So let us take some software engineering questions and answers. First is, what is software engineering? You know, we have a definition of IEEE also, but the various definitions which are given by various eminent personalities. Some basic definition of software engineering is the application of disciplined engineering approach to the development of software systems, a body of knowledge and experience in software development practices and processes. These are very short and sweet definitions, but a disciplined and planned or engineering approach to the development of software or product is software engineering. I like computers, so is software engineering for me? Software engineering is all about using your engineering principles for the production of software. What happens generally that you have to add two values. What you are going to go, or what you are going to do? You will simply choose a language, say C, Java, or any other language, and you start coding it, and you will see the result. Okay, now it is fine. But as this question becomes complicated, you have to add now some complex numbers, and the complexity grows. Then you have to apply these engineering principles. So, if you like computers, like solving challenging problems, and would like to make an impact on the world in which we all live, you should consider software engineering, and you should learn software engineering. You should understand software engineering. So, computer systems are an integral part of today's society. Software is a critical component of all computer systems, which include the embedded systems also, which are the most important aspects today. Software does not hold that prominence as embedded systems are nowadays. They are used in communication networks, vehicles, consumer electronics, medical devices. The software engineers have the knowledge and skill needed to provide a high quality, cost effective software in which all these computer systems actually depend. And some are really vital. Some your software actually guides, say, a nuclear plant. So, or you know, your software is in a rocket. So some BSSE, that is software engineering program, is one of the first four ABET accredited programs in the United States. So there are curriculums, you know, we are talking about certain curriculum which provide a stronger foundation upon which to build a software career, SE career. What is the difference between computer engineering, computer science and software engineering? They all seem to be same. A computer degree in computer science and computer degree in computer engineering, what difference does it make? And software engineering. So while computer engineering, this one, includes courses in software engineering incorporate much more detailing software development practices and process, including advanced areas of software architecture, management, quality assurance, process improvement. So software engineering programs do not stress computer hardware and electronics so much as these computer engineering programs does. Software engineering is based on computer science, as the other engineering disciplines are based on natural or life sciences. However, the software engineering adds an emphasis on the issues of process design, measurement, analysis, and verification. So in general, scientists and computer people seek new knowledge while engineers want to build things, solve problems, and help people. So both roles are important. Why are software engineers needed? Why do we require software engineers? Computer systems are pervasive, and they have major impact in the society right now. So software is a critical component of all computer systems, including the embedded systems, as we said, using various fields. So software engineers, they have this capability to actually work and develop them. I have no previous programming experience. Can I still be a successful software engineer? If this question has been asked, say any previous programming experience that you may have is certainly would be an asset. But it is not a dead requirement. Means it is not a dead necessity. It is very common that software engineering is mainly programming. No, software engineering only 20% is coding. Other parts, means 80% of part is different. In fact, software engineering program put a lot of effort or emphasis on the software development practices and process, which include advanced areas of software architecture, requirements management, quality assurance, and process improvement. What are the characteristics of good design? So name some design tools. We have object-oriented design tools like Rational Rose, Rhapsody, Telelogic. You know, these are the object-oriented design tools. We also have certain user interface design tools like Rapid Paper Prototypes, you know, and SUMI, that is Software Usability or Measurement Inventory, is the, also there. So it will tell you how your product compares to the standardization base, whether you are about average to for the market, below or above. What is SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle? What are the various SDLC models? Explain them. First, we'll talk about SDLC. A software cycle deals with various parts and phases, from planning to testing and then deploying. So from the feasibility study till the deployment or maintenance activity, software development cycle is all about this life. So all these activities are carried out in different ways as per the needs, and each way is known as the software development lifecycle. Okay. So there are various SDLC model. The first and foremost and the basic is waterfall. In the waterfall, there are separate and distinct phases of specification and development. All activities are linearly fashioned. And next phase, this phase will only start when the first one complete. Then we have evolutionary development. In this, software evolves. So specification development are interlinked, like spiral, incremental, prototype, based, rapid application development. All these are evolutionary development. For example, incremental model is what? Waterfall model with iteration. This is incremental model. What is rapid application development, RAD? This focus in developing quality product in less time, rapidly. Then we come to the spiral model. We start from smaller module and keeps on building it like a spiral. It is also a component based development. So in spiral model, the main thrust is on the risk analysis every time. Formal system development, a mathematical system model is also there, which is formally transformed into an implementation. This is formal system development. Agile methods are also there, which includes flexibility, agility into development. Reuse based development, the system is assembled from the existing components. This is reuse based development. What is RUP and PSP? RUP, it is actually Rational Unified Process, RUP. Rational Unified Process, and it deals with iterative software development process, element process, visual modeling of system, quality management, chain control management, deals with role and activity and the artifact. For managing object-oriented software development, some features of RUP, these are, say, online repository of process information description, templates for all major artifacts, which include requirement tracking, use cases, project management, and process manuals describing key processes of PSP, which PSP actually stands for your personal software process, PSP. So the PSP has certain objectives, like to introduce individuals to a process-based approach, or to develop software, and to show individuals how to measure, estimate, schedule and track their work, to show individuals how to improve the quality of their programs. So in general, this PSP improves quality and productivity. So the time saved in testing because of better quality reduces time across the project by, say, 20 to 40%. And there are various advantages of PSP. First, to manage your work and assess well your talents and skills, to plan better, to track your performance precisely, and to measure the quality of your software product. What are the different types of testing in software engineering, and how do you design a test case? First is testing in software engineering. So what is testing? Testing is running the program or product under various circumstances and conditions to find errors and bugs in it. So this is important, as releasing a faulty product will not only cause serious problem to the end user, it will harm the company's reputation also. So there are various kinds of testing conditions in which one to use depends on various type of products. So there are types of testing in software engineering. So as per the test target, there are unit testing, integration testing, system testing as per test objective. So there is user acceptance testing, installation testing, alpha beta testing. And this is called the acceptance testing or system testing. After that system testing, you have acceptance testing, which involves the alpha and beta testing. Also regression, performance, stress, usability, configuration, spoke, that is sanity test. So let us see one by one. Unit testing. The tools used in unit testing, these are debuggers, tracers, and used by programmers only. So unit testing verifies the functioning in isolation of software pieces which are separately testable. One by one. Then comes the integration testing. So in integration testing, according to IEEE, integration testing is an orderly progression of testing in which software elements or components or hardware elements, they both are combined and tested to evaluate their interaction until the entire system has been integrated. So if test against system design and focuses on communication between modules, start with one module, then we add them incrementally one by one. So various type of integration testings are there. There can be Big Bang integration. You can integrate all of the modules at once. Top-down approach, that is keep on breaking the system in parts one by one and then test each part. Bottom-up approach is also there. You test the small part test and then keep on integrating the system to and keep on testing the bigger module. You also have a mixed approach, which is held by, say, stubs, dummy modules. You are aware of stubs and drivers, I presume. Then comes this system testing. So now IEEE defines system testing as the process of testing an integrated hardware and software system to verify that the system actually meets its specific or specified requirements. It is tested against the system specification. So many test manual procedures, restart and recovery, user interfaces, stress, performance, all these may be tested. So in system testing, real data is used and sometimes user participation may also be encouraged. Then comes the objective-based testing. So some of the testing under this category, what they mean are like this: user acceptance testing. Testing conducted to determine whether a system is satisfied, suitable, to find out the acceptance criteria and to enable the customer to determine whether or not the system is acceptable or not. Even the GUI, if it is not accepted, the system may be rejected. So it is done against the requirement and it is done by actual users. Then comes the installation testing. System testing conducted once again according to the hardware configuration requirement. So the installation procedures may be verified. Functional testing. It checks that the functional specifications are correctly implemented. So you can also check if non-functional behavior is as per expectation. Then comes the stress testing, also known as endurance testing. Stress and load testing, these are the part of your stress plus load. They come under the performance testing. So we impose abnormal inputs of the stress, the capabilities of the software, input data volume, input data rate, processing time, utilization of memory, etc. They are tested beyond the design capacity. Then comes the regression testing. Regression testing, according to IEEE, is selective retesting of a system or component to verify that the modifications what you have done, changes you have accorded, have not caused unintended effects. So it is repetition of tests intended to show that the software behavior is unchanged and whatever you have changed so far. So it can be done at each test level. Then comes the performance testing. It is verifying that the system meets the specified performance requirement like response time, volume, etc. Then alpha and beta testing, that is the part of this is just before the acceptance testing. So probably one term that you must be aware of us as we often hear this software is in alpha phase or beta phase or beta phase introduction. Here is testing is done by a representative set of potential users for trial use, and in-house is alpha, external is beta. Then comes the usability testing. So it evaluates the human computer interface. It verifies the ease of use by end users, that is the learning curve. Verifies ease of learning the software, including user documentation. Checks how effectively the software functions in they are supporting the user task. And it also checks the ability to recover from user error. Then comes the configuration testing. So it is used when the software is meant for different type of users. It also checks whether the software performs for all users. These are configuration testing. Then comes the smoke or sanity testing. It is used to verify whether the build is ready for feature or requirement based testing. It is used to verify whether the build is ready for some certain feature or requirement based testing. Recovery testing. It is used in verifying software restart capabilities after a certain catastrophic disaster has happened. Security testing. It is used to verify proper controls that have been designed or not. So security, whether the software is secure enough. So you can intentionally try to check to make the software, you can prove that the software may be insecure. You can see where are all the vulnerabilities, etc. So how to design test case? This is most often asked question everywhere. So a test case will have 5 sections. Okay, so let me tell you how we are going to make the test case. There are various methodology, first of all, you can have test cases like if you are planning for black box testing, then you can apply, or you can rule the equivalence partitioning. Then equivalence partitioning, you can choose the boundary value analysis. And basically, in the basis of boundary value analysis and equivalence partitioning, you can make the test cases. That's what you are going to test. And if you are using this, black box testing and then white box testing. So white box testing has also, you can easily go for complexity checks like McCabe's cyclomatic complexity. So that cyclomatic complexity also tells you that how many test cases you need to generate. And the test cases can be based on the control flow graph, etc. What is SRS, Software Requirement Specification? SRS stands for Software Requirement Specification. So it establishes the basis for agreement between customers and contractors or suppliers on what the software product is expected to do, what it is expected to provide, as well as what it is not expected to do. So there are certain features of SRS. It permits a rigorous assessment of requirement before design can begin. And it sets the basis for software design, test, develop, deployment, and training, etc. It also sets the prerequisite for good design, though it is not enough right now. So it sets basis for software enhancement and maintenance also. And in this SRS, you can mainly consist of your functional requirement and non-functional requirement. What are functional and non-functional requirement in software engineering? Functional requirement are the expected functionality or services from the system as user has expected. User is requiring something that I want X plus Y. This is function. He wants X minus Y. This is another function. So functional requirements, they are system property and constraints. So there, in your SRS, you'll find the constraints also. So now constraint can be on requirement itself. So examples are, say, response time, 24/7 availability of the system, etc. So non-functional requirement. The non-functional requirements are like this, that you want certain performance, you want certain throughput, etc. So what is requirement engineering? Software requirement as they are descriptions and specification of a system. So a requirement is a condition or capability to which the system must conform and define. A system is designed with certain functionality in mind, and to come up with that functionality and its specification right at the beginning is requirement engineering. So requirements engineering, eliciting, organizing, documenting, this is what the answer is. Eliciting, organizing, and documenting the requirements of the system, the process of establishing the services that the consumer would require for a system and the constraint under which it operates and is developed. Software system should be clear, complete, unambiguous, quantitative. These are the software engineering and software principles, guidelines for making a good product is all about. So these are a few questions on software engineering. Thank you so much. Take care.